Αυτά είναι πιο ενδιαφέροντα φαγητά ελληνικά. Προχωράμε στο επόμενο πιάτο. Νομίζω ότι αυτό θα σου αρέσει κιόλας. Εδώ, είμαι μπροστά σου. Okay. Μπράβο. Τι είναι αυτό?
Rice.
Μπράβο.
Okay. Okay,
στην Ελλάδα τα λέμε γεμιστά. Και τα φτιάχνει η γιαγιά μας, η μαμά μας και όλα τα ελληνικά σπίτια το έχουν.
I'm glad I did not have dinner tonight. I don't need.
Okay. Για να προχωρήσουμε στο επόμενο πιάτο.
Okay, another one?
Ναι, αυτό είναι παραδοσιακό επίσης. God. Για να δούμε. Εδώ, όπα. Μπράβο.
Ατόμα, Τόμας.
Μπράβο, λοιπόν, το βρήκε, παιδιά. Το βρήκε. Είναι παραδοσιακό ελληνικό ντολμαδάκι. Είσαι καταπληκτική.
Okay, I'm full.
Δεν θα πάμε άλλο, αλλά πρέπει να περιγράψεις, Παμελά μου, μπράβο.
Okay.
Τι είναι αυτό που θα πιάνεις, χωρίς να δεις ή να μυρίσεις. Ας πιάσουμε το πρώτο. Το βλέπετε. Ορίστε. Δικό σου.
Aubergine. Aubergine. Eggplant.
Συγχαρητήρια, το βρήκε. Μπράβο! Μπράβο! Ελληνική μελιτζάνα! Κριτική, παρακαλώ!
Okay.
Για να προχωρήσουμε στο επόμενο προϊόν.
I'm scared.
No, no, no! Μη σκέφτεστε περίεργα!
What is it? It's like a nut. No, it's
no.
A squash. A squash?
Δεν θα σε βοηθήσω.
Hello? This is squash.
Τι είναι? Είναι λαχανικό, είναι λαχανικό.
I don't want it.
Θέλ το.
It's a squash, no? Squash?
Είναι κολοκύθα.
Κολοκύθα.
Ελληνική. Ελληνική κολοκύθα. Δες το και σαν Halloween.
Oh, for Halloween.
Ναι, μπράβο.
Okay, now what?
This one.
Orange.
Μπράβο, το βρήκε αμέσως. Πορτοκάλι!
Yes.
Μπράβο, συγχαρητήρια!
Okay,
θα σου βγάλω τώρα τη μάσκα. Παιδιά, η Πάμελα είναι φοβερή και με μάσκα και χωρίς. Let me take it. Μπράβο. No, no, no.
Okay.
Ωραία. Δώστε ένα πολύ μεγάλο χειροκρότημα για την Πάμελα που σας βλέπει. Θέλω το πιο δυνατό χειροκρότημα. Πόσο τυχερός άντρας είμαι που έχω δίπλα μου την Πάμελα Άντερσον. Μέχρι τώρα, πώς ήταν η παραμονή σου στην Αθήνα?
Oh, it's been beautiful. Beautiful. I love coming to Greece. I've been here a few times, so it's always a pleasure.
Εγώ θέλω να ευχαριστήσω τη Μεγάλη Βρετάνια για αυτή την υπέροχη φιλοξενία. Να προχωρήσω, γιατί έχω τόσα πολλά να μάθω και εγώ και το κοινό για σένα, που ανυπομονώ να ξεκινήσω. Είσαι έτοιμη?
I'm ready for anything.
Okay. Πόσες ελληνικές λέξεις ξέρεις?
Όχι.
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 No, yes.
Όχι. It's a very important word. The revolution, yes.
Λες συχνά, όχι.
Όχι. Όχι.
Όχι, μπράβο.
Όχι.
Όχι. Μπράβο. Παιδιά, είναι δύσκολο!
Okay.
Είναι δύσκολο να πεις, άμα είσαι ξένος στο κει.
Not too much else. No, like I said, my sons are a little bit Greek, so I heard a lot of Greek in my life, but I can't remember too much. Sorry. How do you say I love you in Greek?
Σ'αγαπώ.
Oh, no, that's it. Σ'αγαπώ.
Γιατί νόμιζα ότι είπες σαγανάκι. No. Σ'αγαπώ.
Σ'αγαπώ.
Μπράβο. Μπράβο.
Σ'αγαπώ.
Πώς πήρες την απόφαση να ζήσεις από την Αμερική στην Ευρώπη?
Well, I live in the south of France. And I shot a lot of pictures in the south of France about 20 years ago, and I knew when my kids were grown that I would live in France.
Πώς είναι η ζωή εκεί; Σου λείπει κάτι από την Αμερική;
Well, I miss my kids, but they come a lot to Europe as well, so I feel like in Marseille, Malibu, I go back and forth. I have a house on Vancouver Island, so I'm always surrounded by the ocean. It just seems it's nice to learn a new language. I left everything to learn a new language, a new culture, and I recommend it to anybody in their lifetime to just keep learning, keep growing, you know, experience new places. And I love French culture. I love European culture. In America, it's not so much culture. So, I love it here.
Μήπως ήταν ο έρωτας που σε έφερε στην Ευρώπη;
Love that made me stay in Europe for longer than I expected. So, yeah, so far I'm still here.
Πώς γνωριστήκατε με τον Αντίλ; Γιατί αυτό νομίζω είναι πολύ σημαντικό.
Oh my God, so funny. It is. It's important. Who knows? You know, it's one of those fated meetings. It's very romantic. It's a romantic adventure because it seems like an impossibility. And I think those relationships are the most interesting. To come from two different places, to speak two different languages. I mean, I'm just starting to realize he's funny, and he's starting to realize that I'm smart. Because 2 years, he's learning English and I'm learning French. So it's kind of it's just taken a while to get to know each other, and every day feels like the first day. So.
Τι θαυμάζεις εσένα ο Αντίλ;
You'd have to ask him. I don't know.
Εσύ τι θαυμάζεις τον Αντίλ;
Well, you know, he teaches me a lot. Patience. No, discipline. He's very disciplined, and I am not a disciplined person, really. So, one of the hardest working people I've ever met, and you know, to be a professional athlete is no joke. It's seriously hard work, and I admire him for that. And you know, he's very generous, very funny, and I don't know, somehow we just have this fire between us, and it works.
Με τη διατροφή πώς τα πας; Έχω ακούσει ότι είσαι vegan ή vegetarian.
Well, I'm vegan in California, and I try really hard to. I cook vegan at home, and he really enjoys that as well because he wants to eat healthy, and it's a great way. It's a great lifestyle. But in Europe, it's a little bit more difficult.
Γι' αυτό και εγώ έφερα μαζί με τσαπάνιες και δύο εξαιρετικά ροφήματα vegan, ώστε αν θέλεις να πιείς, για να σε έχω ευχαριστημένη. Έχεις κάνει 14 εξώφυλλα Playboy, σωστά;
Oh boy, yes, I guess. 14 in America. I think there's hundreds worldwide, but 14 American Playboy covers.
Αισθάνθηκες ποτέ αμήχανη μετά από όλα αυτά τα εξώφυλλα; Ή σε κάποια από τις φωτογραφίσεις;
I was very shy, if you can believe it. I was very shy.
Εγώ σε ξέρω, το πιστεύω, είμαι σίγουρος.
But I got over that fast. It's a real achievement for me to overcome my shyness. I think when people are painfully shy, it's very difficult. You know, we just want to believe what society tells us what is right and wrong. And I really felt a breakthrough when I was able to shoot for Playboy. It was really empowering for me, and you know, it was fun. I didn't realize my sons were going to have fist fights over me in high school. You know, about it. You don't when you do Playboy, you don't realize the repercussions of, you know, when you have children and how they're going to be protective, so. But they've turned out okay. And they're very protective of mom.
Αν γύριζες το χρόνο πίσω, θα έκανες κάτι διαφορετικό;
I think everybody would do, though. I don't know, well, I mean, everything brings you to where you are, so you can't have any regrets, but, I've learned a lot along the way, and I've applied things to my life, to my foundation. Everything I learn, I apply to the way I live, and I try to, you know, be engaged in the world. And I have a lot of causes I believe in, and a lot of things have come from the pain I've gone through, either as a child or things I've seen that have been traumatic. I've tried to see how I can make a difference.
Ακτιβισμός. Τι ήταν αυτό που σε παρακίνησε να ασχοληθείς με τον ακτιβισμό;
Well, my father was a hunter. And the first time I saw a deer hanging upside down with no head dripping blood into a bucket, I realized that was meat, and I didn't want that anymore. And so I convinced my father not to hunt anymore. That was my first job as an activist. And I always collected misfit animals. I had the three-legged cat and a dog that walked sideways, and just misfits have constantly come to me. People, animals, and I think I just have this affinity with vulnerable people. And I realized everything is connected. And when I was on Baywatch, I was getting so much attention for superficial things. And I thought, how can I share this attention with something more meaningful, like animal rights? And we created animal welfare laws where there were none. And so I just, all the progress I made with PETA made me realize that I had a responsibility and I had a voice. And so that just steamrolled into so many other things. Political things, environmental things, you know, women's rights, children's rights, vulnerable people.
Ποια ήταν η πιο ακραία δράση ακτιβισμού που έχεις κάνει για να προστατεύσεις τα ζώα?
Well, I did a campaign for PETA where it was I'd rather go naked than wear fur, but I'd rather go naked than wear anything. So I don't know if that was too extreme. But I've never been arrested, even though I have a lot of friends who don't trust people that haven't been arrested, especially when you're an activist, you get into a lot of trouble. And so I guess I'm very outspoken. I'm very outspoken on Twitter, on social media, and sometimes that will get you into trouble when it comes to, you know, Hollywood or even being shadow banned when it comes to social media. So, and I just want to be as effective as I possibly can be and do them and be as helpful as I can be and make activism sexy, because, you know, activists and veganism,
normal.
Sometimes you think vegans, you know, are have this image, but, you know, vegans are make the best lovers, you know, they're the strongest man in the world is vegan. So we want to bust that myth.
Σε ενοχλεί που κάποιοι λένε ότι εντάξει ρε παιδιά, έχει βγάλει Πάμελα αυτό το πρόσωπο, αλλά πού ξέρει από όλες αυτές τις δράσεις ακτιβισμού? Τι ξέρει από ακτιβισμό η Πάμελα?
I feel the same way sometimes, but I just, you know, like I said, I have a lot of really incredible diverse friends, and I've grown up around a lot of artists, and I think artists are the freedom fighters of the world, and they're such unique thinkers, and I've just kind of had this imprinting of people that are philanthropists and artists, you know, and the Playboy Mansion was my university, you know, and I, maybe that's a little bit different, but I met so many talented people, musicians, actors, and Hefner was such a great influence in my life, just to be a pioneer, to do it your way, to live your life, don't follow the bewildered herd, and just learn and talk. I don't know, I just keep learning. I keep reading and learning, and I think, you know, you're an activist if you read a book. You're an activist if you go to a museum. Just stay engaged in the world, and it's a romantic struggle, but we all have to take part in it, and it's it just makes you feel alive.
Έχεις κάνει τα πάντα. Μοντέλο, ηθοποιός, ακτιβίστρια. Τι άλλο να περιμένουμε από την Pamela Anderson?
Well, I have to do a movie someday. I have to do something. I want to do some short films. I want to, you know, I really love, like, part of my love of France is I love French cinema. I would love to do something very artistic and you know, maybe even some music. I don't know. There's things I want to do. Now my kids are grown. I wouldn't take any jobs when my kids were growing up. I would take little funny things I could do to kind of make a living and put a roof over their head and do things that I was having fun at. But now I have the time to really apply myself to something, so I don't know what I want to be when I grow up.
Σε ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ.
Thank you.
Να ευχαριστήσουμε την υπέροχη Pamela Anderson. Pamela, thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Σε ευχαριστώ που ήρθες στην Αθήνα για την πρεμιέρα μου.